Mein Buntag. I'm Lance, Bud's brother. And if you've seen any of my videos, you know that I have trouble staying on track. Well, this is no exception. The video I'm going to make today is something that people have asked me, and it's something I personally experienced. So has nothing to do with farming. We'll do that in the next video. Okay. What this one's about is how I found my true love and moved to the Philippines. Now, there's about 1,000 viewers who are watching this, who this is appropriate to. There's many, many viewers, and Bud's viewers are very kind, very knowledgeable, and don't hesitate to say their opinion. And that's exactly what we're trying to enlist here, because please feel free to correct me or change anything, because this I just have to tell my experience. And so those of you who are looking to find your true love and move to the Philippines, be sure and read the replies, because you're going to get a lot of good information, I can assure you. Okay, so let's start. Why a Filipino? Well, you probably wouldn't be watching this if you didn't have in your mind to get a Filipino. And the reason I think it's a Filipinas are the number one choice for a life mate is that their DNA requires them to be nurturing. They have a strong sense of moral values. They're family oriented. They're hardworking, and they're fun. Everybody's different, of course, but I'm talking in large. Filipinas are just, as far as I'm concerned, the ideal mate for me, and my wife is one of those. She's a hoot, she's affectionate, she's smart. So anyway, if you want one, I'm gonna talk about that. Okay, as a big brother, as a father, as an uncle, as a grandfather, as a friend, let me just put my two cents out. What you want to find is somebody you can respect and somebody that makes you feel good about yourself. Those are the two hallmarks right there. Somebody that you can respect and somebody who makes you feel good about yourself. Okay? The other thing is, for God's sake, be age appropriate. There are nightmare stories over here about some 60-year-old who's trying to hook up with a 25-year-old Filipina. It never works out. When you were 25, you weren't looking for a 60-year-old female. And you have to realize that no matter how good looking, you know, you are, you are an ATM as far as they're concerned at first. You know, you're not Tom Cruise, even though they make you feel like you are, you're not. And so, age appropriate. The other thing is, you gotta make sure they're not married. And that's not easy. We don't have divorce over here, so, you know, families go together and separate and get married again, even though it's probably not legal and all of that, but it happens over here, and it happens frequently. So, the way you can find out if they're married or not is through the NSO, National Statistic Office. And you get their vitals, the birthday and all of that, and get a lawyer, and they'll let you know if they're married really or not. And I think about the only other way is you live with them for 4 or 5 years. And it's important enough that I'm bringing it up here. Okay, so let's get started on finding your true love, and then we'll move on from there. I think that the best thing you should do, and this is what I advise, is to sit down and write out what kind of a woman you want. You need to talk about age. You need to talk about the kid, the dependence situation, education. I mean, come on, if you've got a PhD, you don't want a high school. It's not gonna work, and vice versa. So if you've got some college, okay, school teacher. Over here, having a college degree everybody gets one. I mean, it's something that they, education is a strong pull in the family. So the chances of you finding somebody who's got a college degree is pretty good. So anyway, write out the kind of woman that you want and be detailed. Okay, if you're talking 12 font, double space, two pages is probably about right. But write out who you want for sure. It's a fun thing to do anyway. Now, the next thing is do the same for yourself. Recent full body photo, don't be putting one from your high school yearbook. No. A recent full body photo. And now is the time to be honest and above board. Be honest and above board on all things. Now is not the time to talk about money, though. The next thing to do is find an internet website. And that's what I'm talking about, finding somebody, because that's what I did. And the majority of guys over here, within the past 5 years, or maybe more, have found their mate on the internet. So where we use filipinocupid.com, I have some friends I was talking to this morning. He was on christianfilipino.com or something like that. And he's very religious, and so is his wife. And you've got these two things done. You've got your portrait of her. You've got a no lie situation about yourself. And again, 12 font, double space, two pages. If you don't write that, you're leaving something out. If you write more than that, well, that's probably okay. Now you found an internet website. Now start having fun. Find that perfect someone. And what do you do when you find that perfect someone? Or you think so? Well, we're going to talk about that in another video. And also, don't forget, look at the replies on this thing, because a lot of these viewers have great ideas and a lot of insight into this. And we're going to talk about that in another video, like I said. So, the next thing that I'm going to try to do. Now, Bud, as you know, is a linguist. I'm not. I can learn about a word every month. So that's what I do. But because I'm slow at this, I'd like to give you like a word or two, and that be my input. So that's what I'm going to do. The first word I think is an important one is please. Palihog. Palihog. Please. Sounds like please. Palihog. So please. Palihog. That's word one. The next word, I think if you'll find this an opportune word to use, it's E-T. It would phonetically spell out E-E-T-E-E. E-T. E-T means chicken shit. I use it all the time. Now, the next thing, and I've had some comments on, is Filipino-isms. Some things particular to the Filipinos. Now, if you by chance give somebody a compliment, wow, you look good today. Is that a new this? Or your baby is just beautiful. Or a compliment of any type. The person receiving the compliment often will say, buyag, buyag. Buyag, 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 buyag. And buyag, buyag means all the spirits who live in the grass and the trees and the air and the rocks, all spirits, please don't use these good words against me. So, buyag, buyag. It's kind of a fun way to do it. But I don't know if it's something out here in the provinces where we kind of tend to go to the old ways, but why not? Let's not let those spirits get a hold of you. Booyah, booyah. Okay? So, that's about all I got for this video. Thanks for watching. If you like me to do this kind of thing, along with the farming and like I said, next week I'm going to do the interview with our priest. If this is the kind of thing you like, let me know. If it's not, let me know. Okay, thanks very much. Thanks for your input in general, but thanks for your input particularly on this subject, how to find a true love in the Philippines. Because there, like I said, I guarantee you there's at least 1,000 guys who are looking to find their true love and move to the Philippines. I don't want to be sexist, but I've never met a foreigner woman who came over here and to meet a Filipino. Now, my daughter came over here and met a Filipino boyfriend, and that didn't work out. But nonetheless, you know, it was all of her American boyfriends didn't work out either. But anyway, thanks for watching.